kind of side note that I'd like to make is that, of course, the Japanese are also very obsessed with user experience in any imaginable way. So whether that's the way your food is arranged on your plate or whether that's the way customer service is done in general, it's kind of like the opposite of a Microsoft approach. So basically, the Japanese don't tend to not throw a product or a software out there that's not perfectly finished and polished and has been tested to death. So generally, anything you use will work perfectly, and that includes mobile phones, and that includes mobile software and mobile content. I think I've maybe had my own phone, which is right here, crash once in almost 4 years now, which is certainly a different story if you compare it to this phone, which tends to crash around once an hour maybe. So this chart, if you want to check it out in more detail later on, basically summarizes all these differences once again, and it's basically the pieces of the puzzle that have made the mobile internet so huge in Japan. Well, if all this stuff is happening, then Japanese mobile industry must be a pretty big business, right? Well, it certainly is. To be precise, it's worth close to 9 trillion Japanese yen, which is around $90 billion. And most of that money, close to 60%, still comes from voice, even though voice is getting much, much cheaper quickly. And close to 30%, however, is coming from data revenues. And around $4 billion comes from content revenues. But it's very important to note that only 10% of these $4 billion actually end up with the carrier, and the rest of it ends up with the content provider. So Japanese carriers have never cared about pure content revenues, which is radically different from operators in many other markets who in the early days of iMode looked at Japan and thought, hey, people are using all this content, we probably can get into the content business and that would be great. Well, it turns out they probably didn't understand the Japanese model quite right, because to a Japanese operator, the availability of attractive content is only a driver for data access revenues. And the average Japanese operator makes 60 times on data than what they make on content. And then, of course, there's beyond content, things like mobile shopping, mobile commerce, which we'll get into sometime in the next few episodes. And there's also things like mobile advertising. But to sum it all up, data is really where the money's at for the carrier, and everything else is just a driver for that.